One of the most important things when setting up a Power BI report is to have some basic measures in your data model. And from my experience, this will save you a lot of time in the future. So let's see how this can be done. But first of all, let's see what kind of data I have in my report. So I head over to the data view, and then we take a look at the sales table, which contains four columns. It contains the column for date, and then we have revenue values, cost values, and the scenario. And now let's assume that we want to compare the revenues from the actuals with the revenues that were planned in the budget. So our first basic measures will be revenue AC, meaning revenue actuals. So I head over to the fields list, right click and select new measure. Then in the formula bar, I need to give a name to the new measure. I want it to be called revenue AC. And this should equal the sum of the revenue column if the scenario is AC. To be able to do this, I need to nest this into a calculate function. So I need to calculate, and the expression, the main formula, is the sum of the revenue column, but only if it is AC in the scenario column. So I want to have a filter, and I need to filter on the sales table, and the filter expression is scenario needs to equal AC. Confirm with enter, and I have the first very basic measure, calculating the revenues from the actuals. But as I said, we want to compare actuals with plan. So let's create one more measure, which is very identical to the one just created, but it will be revenue PL, meaning revenue for plan. So I need to give it a name first. Okay, I call it revenue PL equals, again, it should be the sum of all the columns, of all the rows in the revenue column, if the scenario is PL. So again, I nest this into a calculate function. I sum up the revenue column, but only if the filter from the sales table is scenario equal PL. And now I have the first basic measures, and let's see what they can do in the report. So I jump over to the report view and add a new page. And then I want to add the Zebra BI charts visual, increase the size a little bit. And then I go and take the revenue AC measure and put it into the values field. So now already all my revenues from actuals are summed up. But of course I want to compare it to plan. So I take the revenues plan measure and put it into the plan field. And now you can see that there's already a calculation of the difference between actuals and plan done automatically in the Zebra BI visual. Now let's see this over time. So what I want to do is I want to take the month column from the calendar table and drop it into the categories field. And now I really have the development over time, but as of now, because I don't have a filter for the year, this is different years at the same time. So let's add a slicer so we are able to add to filter to one specific year. So I go here and select the slicer. I want to filter by year. So let's add the year to the slicer and change it into a drop down. And then only select the year 2019. And now I can really see the development of the deviation from actuals to plan over the months of the year 2019. But what if I also want to compare my actuals from this year or from the selected year to the actuals from the year before? Then we need another measure. We need a measure for revenues previous year. Let's create it. I go back to the sales table, right click, select new measure, And this time, the measure should be called revenue previous year. And again, I need to nest this into a calculate function. And the expression is our already existing revenue AC measure. So I add the revenue AC measure. And then there is a function called date add with which I can calculate the previous year. So let's add the date add function. And then I need to indicate the calendar, the date column from the calendar table. So I take the calendar date column. And then the number of intervals in our case should be -1 year. So I type in -1, comma, and then I select year because I want to have the previous year value. Close the brackets. And then I also have now a new measure which calculates the previous year. And actually, I can also add this to the same visual. So I take the revenue previous year and put it into the previous year field. And now you can see, I increase the size again a little bit. You can see that I see at the same time the development of actuals, the comparison from actuals to plan, and the comparison to from actuals to previous year. And these are just the very first basic measures. Of course, with this data set, we could do the same for costs, and we could do year-to-date measures. But there's more videos in the Zebra BI knowledge base where you can learn about more advanced measures. Please make sure to go and look at them. As always, this file can be downloaded from the knowledge base. Make sure to do this and visit us again for more Power BI tips and tricks.